Let's paint a pen, ink and watercolor painting of a charming little boat and its reflections. I have used a poster board or modeling paper for this. Modeling paper is a thick white paper. It provides excellent contrast and it does not buckle when you apply a lot of watercolor to it. This paper is also smooth, so it's excellent for pen renditions. However, do not use a fountain pen on this paper. Waterproof technical pens are fine. Even ballpoint pen is fine. I have done a very light pencil sketch before beginning the pen sketching. For pen sketching, I am using technical pens. These pens have instant drying ink, which is waterproof when it's dry. Here, I had made a slight mistake in the proportion of the boat. It's a common misconception that mistakes done in the pen work cannot be fixed. They can. The art is in hiding the mistake, not in not making it. I am going to paint the darkest darks values using a brush pen. Brush pens are excellent for filling up large black masses. Use short broken lines to indicate reflections as shown here. Make sure you keep plenty of white space in between those reflections. Now let's add some black masses to the boat itself. Here I am using a technical pen to add some finer shadows to the reflections. The hull of the boat is rounded, so make sure you use contour shading technique to shade the hull. Stippling is also an excellent technique to add some rustiness to the base of the hull where it touches the water. I will now keep switching between various tip size pens to add various kinds of shading to the boat and the reflections. This is a purely intuitive process and there are no rules about which tip size pens you should use. Thank you. Now that our sketch is done, let's start painting it. Unlike typical watercolor paper, poster board does not readily absorb water or watercolor. I will begin by first spraying some plain water onto the paper. I want a very loose and expressive kind of look for this painting. Rather than painting the background, I am going to pour paint over the background and use the water already sprayed onto the paper to direct that paint. You can observe here some color pooling onto the paper because it's not absorbed completely. Don't worry about it for now. Use a tissue paper to blot out excess color from the foreground objects. Don't worry if a little bit of color remains on the foreground object. We can easily overpaint it. I also blotted out some color from the background to indicate some clouds and mist. Now begin painting the boat using some thick watercolor. As you can see, the watercolor does not stick to the surface so easily as it would have done on the watercolor paper. But don't worry about it. The final result will still look promising. To create a dark value here, I have painted over the original blue color using some black ink. Ochre yellow is an excellent base color for anything wooden. Apply some bright hue of yellow to create highlights. Now let's finish applying all the colors and let the painting dry. Then we'll come back to add some finishing touches using pens. Use horizontal brush strokes while painting the reflections. Remember, we don't want to fill in everything on the paper. Keep the reflections sparse and abstract. These reflections will also act as a kind of outline for the lower part of the painting. You may have observed that after applying the paint, the darkest values have somewhat lightened. We will use black ink to repaint the bottommost part of the hull of the boat. Let the paint dry completely before starting to apply the pen strokes. Use brush pens and technical pens as you see fit. You can also apply black ink using a watercolor brush. Depending on how much the original line work is obscured due to paints, you may have to redo a lot of line work and shading work, but it is well worth it. Now let's continue adding the darkest values using brush pens and technical pens. Adding some lettering adds a lot of character to a sketch. I have used poster white to add some letters. Poster white is an opaque white watercolor which is very handy for adding some highlights and such lettering. Here is our finished painting. I hope you liked and enjoyed this demo and learned something from it. If you did, consider subscribing to this channel and also press the bell icon to enable notifications. Visit my website to know more about my books, my training courses, and to have a look at my artwork in various media. Thank you for watching. Happy sketching!